This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Tour DuPont was a cycling stage race in the United States held between 1989 and 1996. Initially called the Tour de Trump, it was intended to become a North American cycling event similar in format and prestige to the Tour de France. The tour's name came from its sponsor, DuPont. The race was held in the mid-Atlantic states, including areas near DuPont's Wilmington, Delaware, headquarters. DuPont withdrew their sponsorship of the race after the 1996 edition, and the event has not been run since during the eight-year history of the race as both the Tour de Trump and the Tour DuPont. It was won twice by the Mexican rider Raul Alcala and twice by the American Lance Armstrong. The race was cited as evidence of Richmond, Virginia's ability to host international cycle racing when the city successfully bid for the 2015 UCI Road World Championships. Contents 1. Origins as the Tour de Trump. 2. DuPont sponsorship. 3. Past winners. 4. Legacy. 5. References. Origins as the Tour de Trump. The race was originally sponsored by Donald Trump and known as the Tour de Trump in 1989. In 1990, the idea for the race was conceived by CBS Sports reporter John Tesh, who had covered the 1987 Tour de France and on his return suggested holding a race in the United States to the basketball commentator and entrepreneur Billy Packer. Packer originally planned to call the race the Tour de Jersey. He approached representatives of casinos in Atlantic City for sponsorship, and Trump offered to be the race's primary sponsor and Packer's business partner in the venture. It was Packer who suggested the Tour de Trump name. Speaking at the time of the start of the first Tour de Trump in May 1989, Trump himself stated that when was initially stated, "I practically fell out of my seat. I said, are you kidding? I will get killed in the media if I use that name. You absolutely have to be kidding." However, Trump reportedly changed his mind within 20 seconds, and was convinced by the commercial value of the name. Trump's lawyers subsequently sent a cease and desist letter to the organizers of a Tour de Rump bike race held in Aspen, Colorado. The letter stated, "You are using the name and mark Tour de Rump in connection with an inaugural cycling event. Your use of that name and mark is likely to cause confusion and constitutes trademark infringement, unfair competition and false designation of origin, all in violation of applicable federal and state law." The organizer Ron Crayon's lawyer responded by arguing that his race was a local and non-commercial event. No response was received from Trump's lawyers, and the Tour de Rump went ahead. The total prize money on offer for the first event in 1989 was US$250,000, including $50,000 for the winner of the general classification. This, together with the race's place in the international calendar between the Giro d'Italia and the Tour de France, made it attractive to high-profile riders and teams, but the event did not attract large crowds. Interviewed on NBC prior to the start of the 1989 race, Trump stated that, "I would like to make this the equivalent of the Tour de France." The race filled a gap left by the demise of the Coors International Bicycle Classic, which had been North America's major stage race but which folded following its 1988 edition. Some European teams reportedly missed the Vuelta a España in order to race the Tour de Trump. Greg LeMond at the 1989 Tour de Trump. The inaugural Tour de Trump started in Albany, New York, and consisted of 10 stages, totaling 837 miles 1,347. York, where demonstrators held placards reading "Fight Trumpism, Die Yuppie Dollar Cum, The Art of the Deal Equals the Rich Get Richer, and Trump Equals Lord of the Flies." The 1989 race was won by the Norwegian rider Dag Otto Lauritzen of the American team 7-Eleven, although there was some controversy about the result as Belgian rider Eric Vandererden, who had won four stages and was expected to take the lead in the general classification in the final stage time trial in Atlantic City but took a wrong turn following a race motorbike. The Soviet rider Vyacheslav Ekimov, who took part as an amateur, won the first stage of the race following a prologue time trial. Articles published the following year reported that Ekimov had the nerve to win a stage as an amateur. Racecourse owner Joe DeFrancis's condition that he moored his yacht the Trump Princess in Baltimore Harbor during the race. It finished in Boston on May 13. Entrance in 1990 included 1989 winner Dag Otto Lauritzen, Greg LeMond, who was coming back from a virus and food poisoning, Steve Bauer, who had finished second in Paris-Roubaix that year, Andy Hampston, Davis Finney, Ekimov, in his first year as a professional, and East German rider Olaf Ludwig. The race was won by Mexican rider Raul Alcala of the PGA DM Concord team after two editions. Trump withdrew his sponsorship of the race due to his business's financial problems, according to Packer. Reflecting on the event in 2016, he and Trump parted as good business friends, although he also explained that Trump's personality and celebrity, as well as the scandals surrounding Trump's marriage and business affairs, distracted from the event and annoyed European riders in the race. DuPont sponsorship. After Trump withdrew from sponsoring the event, DuPont became the primary sponsor between 1991 and 1995. National amateur teams took part alongside professional teams. The event attracted well-known competitors, including Lance Armstrong and Greg LeMond, and was attended by high-profile European-based professional cycling teams. In 1996, the Union Cycliste Internationale upgraded it to a 21-ranked race, meaning that amateurs could no longer compete. This made the race the highest ranked outside of Europe and the first North American stage race to be ranked 21. The 1996 race was the subject of a number of legal issues, including a dispute over rights to its profits between the race owners, Billy Packer, and President of the United States Cycling Federation Mike Plant, which resulted in them suing each other. DuPont itself was involved in a dispute about the anti-homosexual employment policies of the local government in Greenville, South Carolina, with the company insisting that the race organizers exclude the city from the route. After 1996, DuPont dropped its sponsorship and the race has not been run since. During its 6 years as the Tour DuPont, the race was won by Dutch rider Eric Brueckink, Greg LeMond, Raul Alcala, Russian Vyacheslav Ekimov, and twice by Lance Armstrong. Over this time, a prologue time trial held in Wilmington, Delaware, became the traditional start to the race between 1992 and 1994. The race included a stage from Port Deposit and Hagerstown in Maryland, but in 1995, South Carolina was included on the route for the first time. In its place, every edition of the Tour DuPont visited Richmond, Virginia. Brueckink won in 1991 by overcoming a 50-second deficit going into the final stage, a 161-mile 259. Tour de Trump. In 1990 and 1993, he beat Lance Armstrong, who had held the leader's jersey going into the final stage. Armstrong's first participation in the race had been in 1991, when he finished midway down the overall classification, according to The Guardian. In 2008, his performance in the 1991 Tour DuPont marked the arrival of a promising newcomer to the sport. In 1994, Alcala and Armstrong returned to the race as teammates, both riding for Motorola. The race took place over 11 stages, covering 1,050 miles 1,690. That, I talked to them a couple of months ago, and they had to make a hard decision. They don't have hundreds of millions of dollars to put into worldwide advertising. They put a ton of money into this event and they built up a valuable franchise, but, like Motorola, corporations change the way they do business. Plant reported that polling had showed that public recognition of the event had grown significantly, but also that awareness of who sponsored it had declined. Historian Eric Reed notes that a DuPont marketing executive characterized the initial sponsorship as a bargain, and that the company claimed that the American press clippings generated by the event weighed 29 pounds 13. Announcement of DuPont's discontinuation of sponsorship. Mike Plant reported that a 1997 event was tentatively scheduled for May 1 to 11, and that he had been in discussions with 10 companies about potential title sponsorship of the race. Past winners: Rider Team 1989 Nor Lauritsen, Dag Auto Lauritsen. 1992 USA LeMond, Gregrig LeMond. Armstrong, Lance Armstrong. Carrot ABCDEFGHI Hogan, Kevin. April 10, 2016. The Strange Tale of Donald Trump's 1989 Biking Extravaganza. Politico retrieved April 12, 2016. Carrot ABC Margolis, John. May 15, 1989. The First Tour de Trump is Over, As We All Know. Chicago Tribune retrieved April 12, 2016. Carrot Becker, Debbie. April 29, 1996. Race Great Conditioning for Trials. USA Today P. They Stand. Philadelphia Inquirer retrieved April 12, 2016. Acrobatic More Than Classic. Peloton retrieved April 12, 2016. Patrick J. Ward Products. Corian FE13 Hypalon Calres Kapton Kevlar Mylar Neoprene Nomex Nylon Serona Teflon Tevec Vespel Viton Zodiac. Zytel subsidiaries and joint ventures. DuPont Pioneer Danisco Soleil. DuPont Danisco Antec International Divisions and Facilities. DuPont Central Research. DuPont Experimental Station Hotel. DuPont Notable People. Eleuthier Irony. DuPont Alfred I. DuPont Eugene. DuPont Francis Gurney. DuPont Francis Irony DuPont Henry DuPont Lamet DuPont Pierre S. DuPont Jeffrey Stanford Agate Anthony Joseph Arduango III Samuel Bodman Norman Borlaug Donaldson Brown Richard H. Brown Wallace Carruthers Uma Chowdhury Thomas M. Connolly Curtis J. Crawford John T. Dillon Linda Fisher Richard Goodmanson Charles O. Holliday Stephen Idle Edward G. Jefferson Ellen J. Coleman Stephanie Kwolek James Linna Rudolph Paris or George Partial Charles J. Peterson William Dale Phillips Roy J. Plunkett John J. Raskob William K. Riley Irving S. Shapiro Richard R. Schrock Joseph Shivers Howard Ensign Simmons Jr. Charles Stein Frederick N. Tebb Chadwick A. Tallman Earl Tupper Charles M. Vest Edgar S. Woolard Jr. Nathaniel C. Wyeth History DuPont Family Hagley Museum and Library Eleutherian Mills E.I. DuPont de Nemours Company Hercules Powder Company Atlas Chemical Industries B. Reactor Manhattan Project Remington Arms Savannah River Site Kinetic Chemicals Conoco Inc. Consolidation Coal Company DuPont Analysis DuPont v. Colon Industries DuPont Motors DuPont Building INCL The Playhouse on Rodney Square, formerly the DuPont Playhouse Chemours Sponsorship Tour DuPont DuPont Pioneer 250 Hendrick Motorsports The DuPont Show with June Allison DuPont Show of the Month Category Commons